To me, coding is about taking an idea that you have in your mind and building something that you can actually see and interact with. The difference between building a car and building a software application is not actually that different. You have to go through the same design process, the same process of creativity and implementation, but you need much less resources. You just need your computer. And that's the beautiful thing about coding, is that you can have just one device that you can create almost anything and distribute it to almost the entire world. There is this perception in society that only the smartest people know how to code or how to program, but actually coding isn't that difficult if you take the time to learn it, but there aren't that many facilities or places to learn to code, which is actually why iXperience exists. I was born in Johannesburg. When I was about 3 years old, my family decided to move because Johannesburg at that time was a fairly dangerous place to be. And quite funny story, but we were planning to move to Cape Town, but along the drive here, we ended up stopping on a farm and not leaving for 5 years. So I actually grew up on a farm, which is quite ironic. Something that I love to tell the students here is that I never actually had access to a computer until I was about 16 years old. That was probably the first time that I ever saw a computer. And that's, for me, it's quite interesting because now that is my life, working with technology and computers, versus my background when I grew up on a farm walking around barefoot, you know, in the fields. When I graduated from high school, I ended up randomly applying to Yale University, sort of like by a recommendation from a friend. I hadn't even told my parents, and then I got a phone call in May from my mom saying, "Oh, you got this package in the post, you should come check it out." And I went home, and it was actually a acceptance letter and a full scholarship from Yale University, which was amazing. Being in an environment that was completely different to South Africa was like being thrown in the deep end of a pool. You know, you're just continually absorbing information and learning. And then after university, I ended up going to work on Wall Street for a couple of years. And after 2 years there is when I ultimately realized that, like, I wasn't really searching for wealth in particular. I was looking to have some sort of impact. And the most pivotal day there was when I noticed I was doing research for a particular report that I was writing, and I saw the unemployment rate in South Africa being amongst the highest in the world, which I guess I was being naive at the time, found very surprising and disturbing at the same time. And it was then that I decided to come back to South Africa and try and do something locally that could have some sort of impact, but also be something sustainable for me to do.
Upon arriving back in South Africa, Aaron quickly came to the idea of launching a summer tech academy, which would take advantage of both the coding and travel interests of young enthusiasts from around the world. He met with an interested investor randomly during a game of squash. Testing the idea, he pitched, and to his favor, the investor quickly took to it.
I opened my email and he had booked us 2 tickets to go to America for 3 weeks. And he said to me, "You know, there's only one way for us to do this, so let's just go." And he had booked the whole trip, hotels, flights, everything. And I was like, wow, this is quite interesting. It was just an idea a week ago, and now somebody's like actually really interested in this and wants to make it happen. So I kind of took a little bit of a plunge and decided to go with him. And we didn't really know what the product was. We didn't really know what we were doing. And when we arrived there, the first day we decided to go to Yale because that was the university that I knew the best. We arrived on campus and we're like, okay, what now? Like, what do we do now? And we decided to like just walk around the campus and speak to some people. And it was actually very awkward because we didn't even know what we were trying to do there. And so those first 5 days in America from the beginning were actually very tough because we had no real idea of what it is we were selling. We didn't really know how to go about selling it. It was very much a discovery process. And that's ultimately what tested our relationship. We're now partners in this business. Both of us had no idea if this was a real thing, if it was going to work. We were now going to spend 5 weeks in America together. 2 weeks later, well, I built a website for iXperience. We started to have a little bit more structure. And ultimately, when we came back to South Africa, we decided, yes, this is something we want to do. There's been so many challenges along the way to getting iXperience up and running, but I think one of the most difficult days was when we accepted our first class, and we then sent out an email saying, okay, cool, can you guys pay your deposit? And 2 weeks later, we had received one deposit. And we were then thinking, did they just not get our email, or, you know, do they not want to come on the course, or what's the problem? And we didn't really know, we thought that every application and every person we accepted was ultimately in the bag, or it was a converted customer. But then we actually realized later that it takes quite a while to take someone who's interested in doing iXperience to actually being a customer or a client that comes to South Africa. So, you know, that was one lesson we learned along the way, is that, you know, it's slightly naive to think that anyone who visits your website is actually going to use your product. You know, that's just people that are interested in your product, and you still have to go through an entire sales cycle. iXperience, in summary, it's a place where people can learn the latest technology skills. Currently, because we're young, we only have one particular program, which is a one-month bootcamp, which teaches people intensively how to build web applications using Ruby on Rails, which is a specific coding language. They come in with no coding experience, and at the end of 4 weeks, an intensive 10-hour-a-day program, they're able to build web applications using the full stack of web development, which is HTML, CSS, JavaScript, Ruby, and Ruby on Rails. The current students that we have at iXperience are all from America. I went to the top universities, Harvard, Yale, Stanford, and a couple of others, to market a summer program for them to come to Cape Town for 8 weeks, spend 4 weeks learning how to code, and 4 weeks interning at a local tech company. And the reason for going overseas first before opening our programs to South Africa is that we wanted to build a reputation and also be able to sustainably grow our business by getting foreign income. This has allowed us to build a top-class facility that we can now offer courses to South Africans at a lower tuition rate in a facility that is world-class. You get a lot more reward trying to build your own business, and even if it failed and I lost everything that I put in, I feel like those lessons that you learn along the way are pretty much priceless. You know, they're experiences that you can't buy by working at a traditional job. And, you know, that is ultimately like paying for an education at the best business school in the world. So I wouldn't say that, you know, when you look back on it, there is no real risk, because whether you make it or you fail, you're learning lessons that are priceless. My name is Aaron Fuchs. I am the CEO and co-founder of iXperience, and I am Youngpreneur.